Hi friends, welcome to the 21st episode of The Potter's Wheel. Today we're in Luke chapter 22, verses 47 through 51. This is actually the last episode of The Potter's Wheel for this entire series, and it's also the last healing that Jesus performed in his earthly ministry. Luke chapter 22, verse 47 through 51 says, "While he was still speaking, a crowd came up, and the man who was called Judas, one of the 12, was leading them. He approached Jesus to kiss him, but Jesus asked him, 'Judas, are you betraying the Son of Man with a kiss?' When Jesus' followers saw what was going to happen, they said, 'Lord, shall we strike with our swords?' And one of them struck the servant of the high priest, cutting off his right ear. But Jesus answered, 'No more of this,' and touched the man's ear and healed him." So I want to give a little bit of the context. Jesus has just found the disciples sleeping and exhausted from sorrow when he's praying in the Mount of Olives. When the crowd asked him, "Are you Jesus?" he replies, "I am." And the whole crowd falls to the ground when Jesus uses language revealing his divinity. So pulling a sword to defend Jesus right after 200 people fell down is really not out of the realm of possibility, if you think about it. And John tells us that it was Peter who struck the high priest's servant, obviously trying to split his head open, and the guy dodged him, and he cut off his right ear. The fact that the slave to the high priest was in the front of the line indicates that he was more than a slave. He was the personal representative of the household of the high priest. So he was a major player in this whole operation. And so Jesus has just stepped up and said, you know, "Hey, I don't want any of this type of thing to happen." And he rebukes the disciples. And then I like to graphically describe this, but the scripture doesn't say this, that he walked over and picked up the ear off the ground, you know, dust it off in a kind of a nonchalant way and reattaches it. Scripture doesn't really say exactly how it happened, but it was an instantaneous healing. And so it really answers to me three real critical questions. The first of them is that, can Jesus heal in a tense environment? Now, as I advance in my own healing ministry, and I hope you do as well, we really want to pay careful attention to the atmosphere of faith that surrounds a healing environment. And we want to do our best through testimonies of Jesus healing and preaching the word of God to amplify that level of faith so that people believe God will do more. But here's a case where there was absolutely no environment given towards healing and Jesus still healed. So to me, this is very encouraging that Jesus can still heal when the atmosphere does not lend itself toward healing. Secondly, does it require the recipient have faith for healing? And here's a clear-cut case where the recipient probably had no faith for healing. In fact, he was against Jesus. And yet, the Lord still healed this man. And so we have a case where the recipient has no faith or doesn't demonstrate any faith or wants nothing to do with the Lord, and God still heals. And so that also increases my level of faith, the fact that I could be praying for somebody and they may be anti-God. They may want nothing to do with this, and yet if the Lord is wanting to heal them, they can get healed. Finally, what happens when an illness or a situation or an injury is caused by human failure? And in this case, the human failure was Peter. John tells us clearly that it was Peter that cut his ear off. He's the only gospel writer to mention Peter by name, but some think that was because the gospel was written decades later. It was the last gospel written. So John revealed the name of the person that cut the high priest's ear off. Maybe it would have placed Peter at risk had this been known. But anyway, no one really knows why John did that. But what happens when an illness is caused by human failure? One of the first healings of a deaf person that I ever was part of was a retired army soldier from the Chilean army who, either by his own negligence or by his leadership's negligence, did not have protective covering for his ear as he was firing weapons. And one of his ears went completely deaf later in life. And he knew it was because he wasn't using earplugs as he fired rifles. And so he went deaf. Well, the Lord gave me a word of knowledge about God wanting to heal somebody that was had deafness caused by a gun. He raised his hand, prayed for him, and he got healed. So it was, once again, it was a case where an injury was caused by human failure. People sometimes will have injuries related to car accidents where they were at fault or they were negligent. And sometimes in our own mind, we think, well, it's my fault. I deserve this. God doesn't care whether we deserve it. He's so loving and merciful. He wants to heal us no matter what. And so with that note, I just want to pray for you that God will increase your faith for healing in this, to me, a passage that ignites faith because it's so against the so many things of that would lead us towards seeing healing occur, yet Jesus still healed the servant, the high priest's servant. So let me pray for you. Lord, I pray for those that are watching this video today, that their faith would increase because they read this passage out of Luke chapter 22, and that they would be encouraged to step out and do things which even appear impossible, like taking an ear and reattaching it. And Lord, I pray that out of this, Lord, their ministry would grow and be more fruitful, and that as they allow themselves to be on the potter's wheel and shaped by your formative process of teaching us how to pray for the sick, that they would move and advance in a greater way toward a successful and a fruitful ministry of healing. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you. It's been great being with you in this last episode of The Potter's Wheel.